Good afternoon, my dear students. Today we are going to start the nervous system. The nervous system detects and responds to changes inside and outside the body. Together with the endocrine system, it controls many vital aspects of body function and maintains homeostasis. Do you remember what is homeostasis? And to this end, the nervous system provides an immediate response while endocrine activity is in the mean slower and more prolonged. Nervous system detects and responds to changes inside and outside the body. Nervous system detects. What are the changes in the outside of the body and inside of the body detected by nervous system together with the endocrine system? Then homeostasis. Do you remember what is homeostasis? It is the internal environment remain constant when the external environment is changing. So in that nervous system, it detects the change in the outside of the body and the inside of the body, and it controls by nervous system together with the endocrine system. It provides an immediate response with the endocrine system. It controls important aspect of body functions. Maintain homeostasis together with endocrine system. The nervous system consists of the brain, the spinal cord, and peripheral nerves. The structure and nervous system. Consists with the nervous system, brain, and spinal cord, and peripheral nerves. The structure and organization of the tissues that form these components enables rapid communication between different parts of the body. The communication between different parts of the body and the tissues through nervous system. For descriptive purposes, the parts of the nervous system are grouped as follows. There are two groups. Nervous system has two groups, mainly central nervous system and peripheral nervous system. Central nervous system consists with brain and spinal cord. Peripheral nervous system consists of all the nerves outside the brain and spinal cord. This is the division of that. The nervous system, this is the nervous system. It has two parts, central nervous system and peripheral nervous system. Central nervous system has contained brain and spinal cord. Peripheral nervous system has cranial nerves and sacral nerves. Then it has three parts, sensory, motor, and mixed. Some are mixed. Sensory means apparent nerves, motor apparent. It is useful to consider two functional parts within the peripheral nervous system, the sensory and the sensory division and the motor division. Motor division, we can divide into two groups. Again, we can divide into two groups, voluntary and involuntary. Voluntary means we can control according to our wish. The somatic nervous system, somatic nervous system, then movement of the voluntary muscles. Involuntary means the autonomic nervous system, functioning of smooth and cardiac muscle and glands. Then it has two parts, involuntary autonomic nervous system, sympathetic and parasympathetic. Some are increasing the heart rate, some parasympathetic decrease the heart rate. Likewise, The peripheral nervous system comprises paired cranial and sacral nerves. Some of these are sensory, afferent, transmitting impulses to the central nervous system. Some are motor, afferent and efferent, transmitting impulses from the central nervous system, and others are mixed with both sensory and motor fibers. It is useful to consider two functional parts within the peripheral nervous system, the sensory division and the motor division. Motor division has two types. What are the two types? The somatic nervous system, which controls voluntary movement of the skeletal muscle. The autonomic nervous system, controlling involuntary processes such as heartbeat, peristalsis, and glandular activity. It means autonomic nervous system controlling involuntary and somatic nervous control voluntary movement of the skeletal muscles. According to our wish, we can control that move. We can do movements. Autonomic nervous system, we can't control. It is heartbeat. We can't control the heartbeat. Peristalsis means bowels working, and glandular activity. The autonomic nervous system has two divisions, sympathetic and parasympathetic also. In summary, the central nervous system receives sensory information about its internal and external environments from afferent nerves. There are sensory nerves in our sensory organs, eyes, ears, nose, skin, mouth, tongue, and the brain also. There are five sensors, and in those sensors we got the impulses, and then it goes to the brain and interpret what is that information, and then react according to that. The central nervous system integrates the process, this input and response when appropriate, by sending nerve impulses through motor nerves to the effector organs, muscles and glands. For example, responses to change in the internal environment regulate essential involuntary body functions such as respiration and blood pressure. Responses to change in the external environment maintain posture and other voluntary activities. As an example, we can't regulate the respiratory function. Respiratory center is in the midbrain. There are three centers in the midbrain, special vital centers, three vital centers, respiratory center, vasomotor center, and cardiac inhibitory centers. You have to remember well those centers. Again, I will discuss with you what are the special what are the centers situated in the midbrain, and what are the function of those. Respiration controlled by that center, respiratory center. And cardiac inhibitory center, blood pressure also control. Responses to change in the external environment maintain posture and other voluntary activities. Then external environment, internal environment, respiration and blood pressure, that because we can't control those things. In the external environment, maintain posture and other voluntary activities. The first sections of this chapter explore the structure and functions of the components of the nervous system, while the final one considers the effects of body function when normal structures do not function. Cells and tissues of the nervous tissue system. Before that, I want to describe what is external environment and internal environment. When we touch a hot thing, that impulse through the sensory nerves, that impulse goes to the brain and interpret what type of sense is feeling. is it hot or cold? Then as soon as it interpret that motor nerve impulse goes to the skeletal muscles of the hand, and then suddenly away from that hot touching a hot thing, temperature. The first sections of this chapter explore the structure and functions of the components of the nervous system. Then hereafter we will discuss the body function and normal structures do likewise. Thank you very much for listening. Here